Welcome to Farm Simulator 2015 with me, Stockoglaws. How are you? I am very well, I hear you all say. Okay, so Stockoglaws is a little bit of a donut. He managed to hire or rent a square baler and a round baler picker-upper, which, that just smacks of derpiness, I'm sorry. There's me saying, it's going to be more realistic and it's going to be a great let's play, there's going to be no mistakes. I've already derped fairly big. But moving on, learning from our mistakes. As I say in all my let's plays, peeps, I make these mistakes that you guys don't have to. That's my excuse anyway. So we finished the field 13. We finished harvesting it. I've moved the harvester in between episodes just down here. To harvest this big field. Now, I know I posed a question in my last episode saying, what are we going to do? How are we going to do this? With just poor little me, Ewan and Zachary. And a lot of people are saying about maybe hiring another harvester, which is a great idea. Before I can harvest this field, I realised that this field is barley, I think. Field 11 is barley. So, and I think my harvester is full of... it's full of wheat. So we need to get rid of that. There's not a lot of room to manoeuvre here. Let me see what I can do here. But obviously selling this wheat will go a long way to help us afford a better... okay. There we go. Cool. Go a long way to afford, so we can afford a better harvester to help us harvest this huge field. Now, in the last episode, I mentioned something called the auto combine mod. Well, I've got it installed, and basically you press 5, and it brings up this little menu here. And I believe it's auto combine. I think what it does is it follows the contours of the field. So that's pretty cool. So you don't have to worry too much about I'm just a bit distracted because it still looks like there's stuff coming out and that we've run out. But yeah, we don't have to worry too much about it going up and down and missing stuff. It's just going to go on the field. But they've also got this one here, which is like circle. So in auto combo mine, it kind of does a circle, which means it does the headlands first. This is what we want, it's more realistic that way. So let's get you set up. Okay, I need to turn around. Let's turn around up here. I'm going to end up driving over the crops and get towed off by you guys. I should have put the header trailer up here. Got a bit more room to play around with. But yeah, this field is huge. Yeah, driving on the grass isn't too bad. Okay, we'll connect the header trailer up. I'm just a bit cautious of driving on the crops. I don't want to be doing that. I think I've totally messed this up. Attach. There we go. Not quite perfect, but I think it does the job. Yeah, so we'll just line you up, and you should literally just follow the contours of the field. That's what I'm kind of hoping will happen. So let's press 5, and let's hire the worker. Ah, brilliant. It was even smart enough to realise that I didn't have the most efficient lineup. And you can see there, it's following the edges. That's really good, that's really cool. Yeah, that's really good. I'm really pleased with that. So we'll let Ewan do this for a bit, and we're just going to go sell the... cool. So we're going to go sell this. Well, Ewan or Zachary is selling this, we're going to go hire a new combine. Oh gosh. Let's see if I can reverse this properly. There we go. Now I wonder if that'll work if I... Which way do I go? I don't go this way at all, do I? So I have to go back to the farm in order to course play this. Selling this wheat. It isn't a lot, but actually, we'll just have a look how much harvesters cost, first of all. We need to get rid of this anyway, because that harvester's on barley and not on wheat. And we can always put this into our silo. What a beautiful sight. We've got a harvester on the right. Ladies to my left, here I am, stuck in the mood. No, okay, sorry. Yeah, I might burst out in this song once in a while. No, I'll tell you what, we'll dump this and... I think we dump it in here, don't we? So we should have 3,000 now into our, in our... Yeah, that's okay. Brilliant. The price of wheat has actually gone up, which is interesting. But we're going to go sell now some canola. So we'll just line up ready to sell some canola. But yeah, we could do with a big tractor to do the... because we've still got this big field up here. You know, we've still got the... Still got the baler there, ready to do some baling. Okay. So we'll start filling with canola. Right. Stop, stop. You do not drive into the wall. I suppose the start position's up here. There we go. Alright, off he goes. Okay, drive. That's great. Just get out here, bit of peace and quiet so we can concentrate. And let's have a look at harvesters then. So we've got 24,000. We're just going to go sell some some canola, I know, but let's have a look at harvesters and what we can afford. It'd be very nice. So, you know, 18,800, that's not a bad price. The Case IH axial flow 7130, okay, for 18,500. What else have we got? We've got the New Holland CR10 at 35, just under 35,000. Okay, the Russell Marsh, that looks a bit of a beast. Got some John Deere demos, which are, they're quite expensive. John Deere demo and an S690i. What have we got here? W550. Yeah, I think I think I'm going to go with this one. 18,800. Yeah, so nice big harvester. We can afford it. Or we could just get another one of these Sampo Rosinlu Comica. Or Comia. C9. That's not a bad shape. We're going to save ourselves a lot of money if we get one of these. Let's have a look at our headers. What have we got? Okay, there's a... Yeah, that's 14 foot. With a case, we can get 35 foot. But we need a header trailer or something. Header trailers, okay. That's a 40. So that can hold a 40 foot trailer. That's a 24. Okay, have we got enough for that? Let me think. Axial, 18,800. Oh, that scared me then. I think we're going to rent this one. We're going to have the 35. We're going to rent that at 4,000. And we should have enough for the 40, 1,056. We're going to rent that as well. Boom. Now we've got $187 to our name. Okay. Stuff should all be over here being delivered. Let's run. I'm running a bit weird, I know, because I'm using the shift on the left shift. I'm not using the WASD keys. I'm using the up, down, left, right. And if you know me, I'm a proper gamer. I use the up, down, left, right. There's our money going in. So we've got a bit more money. Right. Let's set this up and put it on the trailer. I'm just going to pause the episode. I'll be right back. Right. Okay, we're back. Yeah, sometimes when you rent a new vehicle, something kind of goes wrong with the I don't know what to call it, the controls to put the handbrake on and the ignition mod. Something a bit weird happens to it because you can't turn off the handbrake. It won't let you turn off the handbrake, unfortunately. Let's attach that. Ooh. Now, which way does this go on? I think it goes on that... the other way. So let's... Is it that way? No. Goes the other way. Okay, that's no problem. So obviously we've got to put it on the trailer, otherwise we're not going to be able to take it to our field. Now, as much as I think I need to do this. Now, I don't know how well this is going to latch onto this trailer. Can I lower the header? No. I guess I just... Ah, lower header, there we go. Check it out. That looks great. Okay. Well, it's kind of not on, but... We'll see. We'll see if that lasts. We're going to be in all sorts of trouble if it doesn't. Okay, there's no way to connect this trailer, is there, to the... No. Okay. That's great. Right, let's head off back over to the field. And we'll have to get the tractor to take the trailer. The header trailer over. So we've got a bit of money. We've got 7,000, so that's like our emergency fund. But, I know it seems like we're wasting a lot of money. We're not actually owning any of this equipment. We're just... But... We're going to be making an absolute small fortune. This time next year, we're going to be millionaires. Oh, this harvester is quite big. Don't think it quite fits this road. Somebody said in the comments asking me how actually, wide are the roads around Gloucestershire? Well, there are some roads that are like this, for sure. Especially, near the forest, in between these farm fields. Yeah, there definitely are roads. Although, this road looks quite quick, unpotholed, and it looks quite smooth compared to the roads we get round here. But just need to set all this up. We can actually run two combines together using the auto combine mod, which we'll have a go at doing. Okay, well, he must have done a complete... No, he hasn't done a complete circle, has he? That's incredible if he has. Right, we'll just leave you there. Oh, he might have done. Possibly. Okay, you stop, driver, because I'm paying you £887 an hour. We'll take you over and we'll unload the harvester so the harvester can carry on harvesting that field. I do love the logistics of this, setting it all up, putting a bit of a plan in place and kind of actioning the plan, and I do like that. I wonder if there's a mod, when you're inside the tractor, the windows kind of look a little bit bluish, don't they? They look a bit fainted and a bit tinted, which is realistic for sure, but I wonder if there's a mod that'll make that clear. I don't know, it seems like it kind of ruins the splendor of the scenery and the detail and the amazingness of this map, and just looks a, just looks a bit of a weird color. Well, there might be something in my settings, I don't know. If you know, then please leave a message down below. Cool. We'll unload you in. So what, we'll leave that there. And we'll go get the header. So I'm sure this is going to pay off. Technically, hiring these machines to harvest this field hasn't cost us anything. Technically, because we sowed a bit of canola from stock. We sowed, obviously, we harvested that one field, number 13. But everything we get from the big field is going to be money in our pocket, which is great. Right, hopefully this works and it doesn't fall off. I'll be very disappointed if it falls off. Ooh, so time to be disappointed, I guess. I hope it kind of locks on or latches on and it just looks like it's going to fall off. Nice touch. Stay. Stay. Good girl. Good girl. Oh my gosh. Have I got enough power to get out? Yep. Which one's a less steep way of getting down? Good girl. So far, so good. Alright, we're doing it. We're doing it. So just gotta take things quite wide. Look at the size of it, it's huge. I don't know if I can get in this corner. Might need to go up the curb a little bit. And then round. Ooh. Oh, you see the rear steering as well. That's really cool. Okay. Alright. Hopefully, danger averted. All you need now is a car to come the other way and you... Oh. That's a dangerous thing, isn't it, about driving in the country. There's no way I can turn or reverse, so... You see a car. Have you noticed as well that when you're driving in the country and another car, you know, kind of meet in the middle and you're like, technically, you know, it's harder for me to reverse or, you know, but the person in front of you is so stubborn that you end up reversing, you know, half a mile to get out of their way because they won't reverse. Right, which way is the thingy on? Okay, so I could do... Well, I'm going to go up here and turn around. Let's go up here. Good to me. So we can come up with the combine, pick this up. What have I done? Okay, I might need to reset that. Let's just turn that off for a minute. Okay, this is the... Yeah. This is the other combine. Maybe I can just give it a bit of a nudge. Let's see if I can... No, that is stuck, isn't it? There we go. Okay, good. I know it's not realistic to nudge, you know, probably a half a million pound combine harvester into a tractor trailer, but it works. You can see my methods. Just realised that the wind mirrors are really far away on this thing. So we're going to try and do something cool now. We're going to try and get two combine harvesters going together. Like literally go around the whole of the kind of go around the field together, if that makes sense. So let's line this one up. This has got a nice big header on it. Okay. Now yours. We might plan this well. It might, Actually, think about it. This field isn't that big. It isn't. It's not taking that long, really. With this one little harvester, but we'll get it done with these two harvesters. I'll keep building in course play. It's not course play, is it? It's this one. Auto combine. Alright, okay, so dismiss the worker just for a moment. Oh, don't drive on the crops. Alright, let's unload you. Oh gosh. Wow, that trailer is getting battered today. Alright, we'll unload you and then we'll try and set this up so these two harvesters are going to work together to get this field done. I don't quite know what's going to happen when they run into those poles in the middle of the field, but we'll kind of cross that bridge when we come to it. Well, I'm quite excited about this. I've never used this before. I've never done it. I have seen it being done. So, fingers crossed it will work. But already I'm a massive fan of the this mod. You know, to do the headlands. That's great. Okay, cool. Yeah, let's put you over here. Okay, so number 5, distant keeper is on. This one, no, not pause play, number 5. So I guess we hire, whoa. Ooh, funny things happen when you when you're in that menu. Whoa! Easy, tiger. So 5. We auto. Unload mode. Hire worker. Why can't I hire worker? What am I doing wrong? Okay, I'm gonna just have a quick think about this. I will be back in a second. Okay, I think I figured it out. It's because I didn't have the harvester extended, expanded. I didn't have the harvester expanded, so I don't think it. There we go. We can actually do it now. So that's on. So you do that. So that's okay. I don't know why it's missed that bit there, but so that should be doing that one. Then we wait a little while, and then we do this one. So keeper, distance keeper, and we kind of hire the worker. So I want you to start from here. No. You don't like that, do you? Okay. Oh, this is so much fun. Stop. It looks a lot easier when the person was doing it before. Okay, why is he leaving marks in my Let me turn this on. I think that's working. Okay. Things are going peak tong. Not quite sure what's going on here. I tell you what, I think I'm just going to leave it and just cut it normally. If anybody can see what I'm doing wrong here, please please let me know. So let's not keep that on. You're not cutting anything. Why aren't you cutting anything? Turn on harvester. That's better now, I'm cutting. Doesn't want to cut it for some strange reason. I am not sure. I think it's got to do with the other harvester. Let me move you out the way. Oh. Come on, please do this. Look, I'm pressing the record button and you're not working for me. This isn't fair. Yeah, okay, I'm doing it by hand. So let me try it now. He's not cutting it, is he? No. Okay. I don't know what I'm doing, but I'm going to leave the episode there. If I figure it out, I'll probably show you and explain you next episode, but thank you very much for watching. My name is Stockoglaws. This is Farming Simulator 2015, the Thornton map. Take care. And try for now. Come on now, let's get together in perfect harmony. I got 20 acres, and you've got 43. Now I've got a brand new combine harvester, and I'll give you the key.